this GIMP workshop tutorial for beginners, we are going to remove the background from an image and make it transparent. When we've opened GIMP, we go to File in the menu bar. Then we go to Open. Search for the image that we want to use and open it. There's a download link in the video description for the image used in this tutorial. When your image doesn't fit in the window, you can go to View, Zoom, and Fit Image in Window. Go to Layer, Transparency, and hit Add Alpha Channel. In the Layers panel, we can see that the font changes from bold to normal. This indicates that this layer now can have transparency. Although we are going to remove the background, we are first going to select our subject. There are many ways in which we can do this. One of the easiest ways is by using the Free Select tool. Click in the toolbox to make it active. Hold the Control key and zoom in by rolling the mouse wheel. We can click note after note to select our subject. But when you have a steady hand, you can also click and drag to make a line. Pressing the backspace key lets us undo one or more previous made notes. Then we can just continue. When we press and hold the mouse wheel down, the cursor changes into the Move tool. We can then, by moving the mouse, move the image. Letting go of the mouse wheel gives us the Free Select tool again. This moving of the image can of course also be done with the scroll bars. When we make a selection, it's usually best to stay just a little bit inside the boundaries of our subject. Selecting hair can be a bit difficult, but later on we will see how we can make it look better in this particular image. When we are at the bottom of our image, we can just click outside the image and move to the other side. For the sake of the tutorial, we'll speed up the video until we are back at the first note. Now we click the last note over the first note. Then hit Enter or double-click in the selection to apply it. Go to View, Zoom, and click on Fit Image in Window. With this image, there are several areas inside the selection that we also have to remove. Go to the Tool Options. At the mode, we click on the third button, which is Subtract from Current Selection. Select the remaining areas in the same way as you did with the girl and the suitcase. And again, we go fast forward. Click Ctrl-Shift-J to fit the image in the window. Now go to Select and click on Feather. We feather the selection line with 5 pixels and click OK. In this way, the edge of our selection is not so hard, but it looks more natural. We've now selected the object, but we want to remove the background. Go to Select and click on Invert. We can see at the marching ends at the edge of the image that the background instead of the girl is selected. Then we go to Edit and click on Clear to remove the background. The checkerboard structure that we see now is the transparency. Go to Select and hit None to deselect the selection. Now we will work a bit on the hair to make it look more natural. Go to the toolbox and make the smudge tool active. Then we choose brush Bristles 02. Change the size to about 15 or 20. This depends also on the size of our image. Bigger image means bigger brush and smaller image means smaller brush. Smudge the edge of the hair like so to make it look more natural. this is done, we go to View again. Click on Zoom and Fit Image in Window. Now to finish off, we're going to export our image out of GIMP. Go to File and click on Export As. Contrary to what you would expect, we have to go to Export or Export As and not to Save or Save As. Here we can search for the destination folder. And here we can give it a name, but do not hit Enter yet. Images with transparency always have to be exported with a PNG extension to keep the transparency. So click on Select File Type, scroll down to PNG Image and click on it. The extension behind the image name is now changed to PNG. You can also just type in the extension behind the image name. Now we can click Export. In the dialog box that pops up, we can just click Export again. And that's how you do it. I hope this helps. Please take a moment to give it a thumbs up and leave a comment. Thanks very much for watching.